Minister for Energy and Petroleum, Mr. Emmanuel Kofi Boah, today answered questions on generation of power to some communities. Lawmakers wanted to know when the generation of power will be extended to 6 communities in the Sumu municipality will be finalized. Echuma Nkunya constituency and Fijasi Setre East constituency, respectively, are without electricity supply.
Power supply has been a major source of worry for many, including those in the rural areas and some communities. Parliamentarians in charge of these communities today expressed worry over power generation issues. The Minister for Energy and Petroleum, Mr. Emmanuel Amah Kofi Boah, was asked to brief the House about plans put in place to ensure that people within these communities have access to electricity. Addressing the issue, the minister said his ministry is undertaking a feasibility study to determine the cost of a project to extend electricity to these areas.
We have already identified these communities and feasibility study is being done. We are going through approval processes. We believe that all of these processes, including approval from cabinet and parliament, should be able to do this before the end of the year. As soon as all those processes are done, I believe we will start the real implementation of electrification to this community.
Members also deliberated on issues that have been brought before Parliament for consideration. Setbacks in the education sector, such as lack of infrastructure to support the growing demand of secondary school education, and geographical inequalities in terms of successful completion of basic education, were issues highlighted. Available statistics indicate that secondary school enrollment has increased by more than 71%. On the issue of selection of beneficiaries of the scholarship scheme, some members of parliament were not happy with the criteria for selection and urged the Select Committee on Education to take a second look at some of the criteria for selection.
Any student who takes care of himself or herself, how is the ministry going to identify this group? Disabled students without support. What mechanism is going to be used to determine this? Yeah. Orphans without support. Who is going to be in charge of this to identify this group? Mr. Speaker, I can go on and on, but let me go to the next page, page 6. Mr. Speaker, if you look at E and F, students from LEAP beneficiary households, you look at F, a student in a household with income below the minimum wage, which is 5.24 cedis in 2013. Mr. Speaker, that criteria is also used in identifying a LEAP beneficiary. That criteria is saying, we are going to fund you. What type of signal are we sending? You choose to have 10 children, and you say you are unable to support them. And this guest house and this government is saying, we will fund your children. Mr. Speaker, we have to be very careful. We cannot encourage people who choose to have plenty of children but know that they cannot afford them. But that is the criteria that is here. Mr. Speaker, this is unacceptable. And this House cannot encourage people who want to procreate for their own benefit.